What's happening everyone, Nick here from TV Box Top, and today I got my hands on a powerful Windows mini PC from AEROFARA, and this is their latest model called the AEROFARA Tank56. This is a powerful mini PC running on the Ryzen 5 5600U hexa-core CPU and the AMD Radeon Vega 7 graphics mobile GPU on 16GB of DDR4 RAM and 500GB of M.2 SSD storage. The Tank56 falls within the high-end category of mini PCs designed for high-performance gaming, video and graphics editing, and 4K HDR video playback with HDCP protection for premium streaming. So up next, you have my full review on its hardware and features, and I'll test its gaming performance, 4K video playback, surround sound audio output, and I'll attempt to install alternative operating systems such as Android, x86 and FidoOS. So don't go anywhere, that's up next. So welcome back, and in this purchase contains the Tank56 model itself, one high quality HDMI cable, a 19V 3A DC power adapter, a bracket and screws for mounting to the back of your monitor, and a user manual. So its body is made entirely of metal with the AEROFARA branding to the top. At the front it has two USB 3.0 ports, a USB Type-C display port, a headphone jack, a reset button and an LED power button. To its rear has two HDMI 2.1 ports, two USB 2.0 ports, one RJ45GB LAN port and its power delivery port. To its right it has a micro SD card slot and its intake vent, and to its left its exhaust vent. And to its base it has screw holes for mounting to the back of your monitor using the included bracket, and four anti-skid rubber pads that you remove to gain access to its internal components and its expandable storage facility. So I've already completed the Windows 11 first startup wizard and logged into my Microsoft account, and let's first take a look at its basic system information. So it shows here that the processor is the AMD Ryzen 5 5600U with a base clock speed of 2.30 GHz. It has 16GB of RAM, and this is a DDR4 memory, and it's a 64-bit operating system. Under product key and activation, it shows that Windows is activated. For a more detailed look at its system and hardware information, Ada 64 Extreme shows that its CPU is a hexa-core CPU, and for clarity, this is 5 cores, and it has a boost clock speed of 4.2 GHz. It comes with 16GB of DDR4 SD RAM by way of two Kingston 8GB 2666 RAM modules, each with a frequency of 1333 MHz. Its display is powered by the AMD Radeon Vega 7 mobile GPU with 512 MB of memory, 448 shading units, and clocked at 1333 MHz with OpenGL version 4.6. Its audio adapter is the ATI Radeon HDMI AMD K19.5. Its M.2 SSD is the Kingston NV1 500GB NVMe with a sequential read speed of up to 3500 MB per second and a write speed of 2100 MB per second. It also shows the 1TB Western Digital SATA SSD I installed using its expandable storage facility. Its network card, which is also removable, is an Intel Wi-Fi 6AX 210 dual band adapter, and its Bluetooth version is 5.2. So that's its system and hardware information, and let's now look at what features it has under Windows. It has 4K 2160p display with HDR with a refresh rate of 60Hz. You get a display rotation to portrait mode, reverse portrait and reverse landscape. This feature comes in handy with vertical monitors and projectors. You get a three-way monitor display with the option to add a fourth wirelessly. It has HDMI HDCP protection, allowing you to watch paid subscription services such as Netflix, Disney+, Amazon Prime Video in 4K resolution with Dolby Atmos. and when connected to a 5.1 or 7.1 surround sound audio system, you get Dolby and DTS surround sound audio options.
Prepare to experience something spectacular with the sight and sound of Dolby technology. This is Dolby Atmos. Now, sound moves around you in three-dimensional space with breathtaking audio quality. It brings the on-screen action alive and immerses you in every moment.
So this test reveals that it can output Dolby Atmos, Dolby True HD, Dolby Digital Plus, Dolby Surround, DTS HD Master Audio and DTS-X. And if you would like to get your hands on this receiver that can play all of these various formats, you can find it at a reduced price using the link in the description below. And for the playback of self-hosted videos, it can play 4K HDR, HLG HDR, and videos with the new AV1 formatting, as well as all of the previous legacy HDR formats. Please note there is no adaptive HDR feature on mini PCs. It's either you leave it on or off, and in this demonstration I have it turned on. For video editing, with Camtasia set to 4K UHD, editing and playing the timeline is really smooth, which is impressive for this mini PC. For work and presentation, you can install all your office applications such as Microsoft Word, Excel spreadsheets, and a PowerPoint presentation, and connect this to a big screen or a projector and carry out professional office work like a pro. Let's take a look at its gaming performance on the Windows. On high graphics settings, this mini PC handles itself pretty well.
But you still have to take your chances. Brilliant.
Now it's Kane. Sterling. Cleared away. Kane. And into the grateful arms of the keeper.
And this is its PS2 emulation performance. So its emulation performance is outstanding and it can handle any PS2 game you throw at it. a look at some benchmarks. First, its RAM copy speed. Its 16GB of LPDDR4 RAM has a RAM copy speed of 31,581 MB/s. Its M.2 SSD has a read speed of 2,502 MB/s and a write speed of 1,838 MB/s. Next, the results of the test performed on its Wi-Fi 6 bands and its Gigabit Ethernet LAN port. Based on a network speed of 154 Mbps, the 5 GHz band and the LAN port reached the maximum speed of the network. The 2.4 GHz band, on the other hand, achieved 40%. Next, the test performed on its powerful AMD Ryzen 5 5600U CPU with a boost clock speed of 4.2 GHz for single-core and dual-core performance, and it generated a score of 1,378 single-core and 6,032 multi-core. These are very high scores, the most I've seen in a mini PC. Next, the test performed on its AMD Radeon Vega 7 mobile GPU for gaming performance generated a TimeSpy test score of 1,211. This is also a very good score, and it also showed during its gaming demonstration. In the AnTuTu benchmark, it scored 670,538. And in the PC Mark 10 comprehensive benchmark, it got an overall score of 5,039, a web editing score of 3,913, and a web browsing score of 8,560. So those were the benchmarks. Let's now see where it places on the chart. So the scores are in, and we have a new number 1 mini PC on this chart, and it's called the AEROFARA Tank56, and it took this position based on its PC Mark 10 benchmark score. So if you would like to view this chart where you can compare its benchmarks to other models in this list, see the link in the description below this video. And to close off this review, as promised, I attempted to install Android x86 and FidoS. Firstly, I tested various versions of Android x86, and most of them failed to install with the exception of the Andex Exton Android 11 version. However, it's useless because it doesn't recognize its Wi-Fi hardware, nor does it recognize its Ethernet LAN port. The issue is, most of the Android x86 versions cannot recognize the AMD Ryzen hardware as they were more designed for Intel. When I tried to install FidoS, it gets even worse as the installation process is halted as it cannot recognize its Wi-Fi adapter nor its Ethernet LAN port, so you can't proceed with the setup process. However, with that said, this segment of my review is purely experimental and does not reflect negatively on its performance as an official Windows PC. In summary, the new AEROFARA Tank56 is my most powerful model to date, taking the chart at position number 1 for its performance and features. I had no issues with its performance, and its hardware is relatively new, so the issue faced when I tried to install alternative operating systems and not having some of the drivers for its hardware is quite understandable. The one thing I wish it had was an additional M.2 port instead of a SATA expandable storage cable. So this, my friends, is the most powerful mini PC for the year, and it has the benchmarks to back it up. So to get your hands on this model, it's currently listed on Amazon, but it's currently unavailable. So the only place you can get it at this time is on their website. See the link in the description below this video. Give this video the thumbs up if you enjoyed my presentation. Test material used in this video, such as the surround sound audio receiver, and tutorials for installing Android x86 and FidoS can be found in the description. If this is the first time viewing one of my videos, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring that notifications bell to support this channel and to receive notifications when I release new videos or decide to do a giveaway. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.